सच्चिदानंद स्वामी महाराज ने जय, अक्षर पुरुषोत्तम महाराज ने जय, दिनकर भाई महाराज ने जय जय जय। सो हैप्पी बर्थडे दिनकर अंकल, हैप्पी अक्टूबर फर्स्ट एवरीबॉडी। एंड आई रियली एंजॉय दिस टाइम ऑफ ईयर बिकॉज व्हेन वी स्टार्ट सेलिब्रेटिंग ऑन लेबर डे वी बेसिकली सेलिब्रेट फॉर अ होल मंथ एंड दिस ईयर विल बी सेलिब्रेटिंग ऑल द वे थ्रू फेब्रुवरी ऑफ 2020 बिकॉज we will have in Pawai, right, the double celebration of Dinkar Uncle and Bapu's 75th birthday. So I'm going to be pretty brief, but I just remember that when I was just thinking that when in preparing for this, you know, for the event that we had, everybody was a part of them, a lot of interviews that we took. Many people shared their experiences, whether it was for the videos, for the kids' book, for Parikshit's book, and you know, they were all really great. I mean, very touching, and, you know, I mean, a lot of people shared so much personal, you know, really deep personal things. And a lot of the things, you know, I said this before, is that a lot of the things in the kids' book and Pariksha's book and the videos are some of the same prasangs. So definitely at least read the kids' book if you haven't. And if not, I would just suggest it another nice way to learn about each other and, you know, share Dinkar Uncle's Mahima is to just start asking each other, like, hey, what did you do for the interview? What did you say? What did you write? It's just a suggestion. But people had different questions, so everyone was in it in one way or the other, and, you know, we can all learn from each other. But what I took away from watching, for at least watching the video ones, was one of the things that people, you know, a lot of people mention is that Dinkar Uncle is really down to earth. He's, you know, he's so down to earth, you know, he comes to our level. There's a lot of experiences that say that. And, you know, that really is, for a lot of us, that's the foundation of our relationship because it makes it easier for us to share with him and it makes it easier for us to relate and be open with him, which is, I mean, just from what I heard and read, that seems to be like one of the number one qualities is that, you know, it's easy to be open with him. And then, you know, several people had mentioned, like, Devabai and Shuradbai, that he lives the life the way he does so that we can learn from it. So this, you know, this discipline he has for himself that, you know, he's teaching us by doing it. But, you know, we all know he comes to our level when it's for us, but for him, he's got a very high standard, and you know, I was thinking like this is basically the same method, right? That Nilkanth Verney did too. Nilkanth Verney did not have to do all that upvas. He didn't have to do that penance. He didn't have to do that extreme tap for himself, but he did it to show us that it was possible in this human body. And so, in this day and age, you know, Dinkar Uncle shows us the simpler techniques of how it is possible to be Brahmarup in this human body, right? I mean, and those are the little things that we know, like Shrodbai had mentioned, you know, he starts reading his Swamini Vato and, you know, Garuda Middle 33 and things. I mean, he literally starts that within the first like 10 minutes of when he wakes up. You know, he ends his day reading Sunrit. Like these are, you know, things that he does not miss. He does Dune nonstop. And for those of us that can't do the Dune ourselves nonstop, he plays it. You know, he does all of these things for us to learn and like, he had said himself is that his hope is that we will start doing the same. And so, you know, I guess my prayer is I realize that as much as I enjoy and appreciate, you know, Dinkar Uncle's coming to my level, if I want to enjoy his Akshardham at his level, I really have to try harder. And I'm not good at resolutions, but my prayer is to really start making smarter choices and to include more of your liking and less of my liking when it's not the same thing. Sajanan Swamaraj Nijay.